Good afternoon. I'm Jim Vaughn.
And I'm Melanie Falcon. 16 people are suing B. Braun Medical and alleging its Hanover Township plant gave them cancer, including some former employees.
Our business and policy reporter Justin Backover joins us live with more tonight from the facility. Justin, what can you tell us?
Yeah, Jim and Melanie, concerns were raised back in 2019 with residents over data from the EPA that showed that this facility in Hanover Township was emitting ethylene oxide, which is used to clean medical equipment and is a known carcinogen. Now, the case was filed today in Philadelphia County, and I got to talk exclusively with the leading plaintiff's attorney.
Cancer victims and their families are taking aim at B. Braun over their exposure to ethylene oxide, a colorless, odorless gas used to sterilize medical equipment.
And it's a terrible hazard to the Allentown community. We have, regrettably, 16 clients.
Of the 16 clients, three have already died. Shane Inspector is a founding partner of Kline Inspector in Philadelphia, the firm representing the plaintiffs. The case has been filed in Philadelphia County.
The cancers that are developed are several in nature, and there is strong epidemiologic and toxicologic support for the causative relationship between ETO emissions from the B. Braun facility in Allentown and the development of these particular cancers.
Specter also filed a complaint with the EPA and asked the Pennsylvania Department of Environmental Protection to investigate the emissions and order remediation.
It's my hope that the problem will be fixed if it has not already been fixed.
B. Braun did not respond to WFMZ's request for comment, but in a 2019 statement, the company said the EPA did not raise concerns with them at the time and that their ethylene oxide emissions have reduced over the last several years. It's unclear whether the company has stopped emitting ethylene oxide altogether.
We're going to see, as part of the discovery process in the civil litigation, what they have to say about the current conditions.
And that discovery process, Mr. Specter says, could potentially go on for years before the case goes to trial. Reporting live in Hanover Township, Justin Backover, 69 News.
All right, Justin, thank you so much.